Are we live? Good morning, friends. Or should I say good afternoon? I am Dr. Abhishek Srikhande. I'm a consultant nephrologist and renal transplant physician at SL Raheja Hospital, Mahim, in Mumbai. So today we are going to discuss about chronic kidney disease, matlab kidney ka problem, and how to retard the progression. The kidney ka problem ना बढ़े इसके लिए क्या क्या कर सकते हैं उस बारे में हम डिस्कशन करेंगे. तो आज का टॉपिक बहुत इम्पॉर्टेंट है. वी ऑल नो दैट किडनी प्रॉब्लम इज अ मेजर हेल्थ हैजर्ड इन इंडिया एंड ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड. इट फॉर्म्स अ मेजर बर्डन इन द इंडियन हेल्थ सेक्टर. सो वी हैव मेनी पेशेंट्स ऑन डायलिसिस. सो हाउ टू स्टॉप द प्रोग्रेशन ऑफ किडनी डिसीज दैट इट लीड्स टू द एंड स्टेज किडनी डिसीज. That is needing the patient needing dialysis. So what we can do? So we know that the major problems for kidney problems are mainly due to diabetes, high blood pressure, also known as hypertension, and aging population. If you have any queries in between, you are free to pop up so I can take them as and when I can see them. So we can see that diabetes is a major problem of the kidney disease. So main thing at present is to control the diabetes. Second thing is hypertension, that is high blood pressure. Use the proper medicines at the proper dosages and be in proper follow for diabetes and the blood pressure with your concerned doctor. Also avoid the medicines which are causing harm to the kidneys. So we'll like to discuss in two ways. First is the primary prevention and second is the secondary prevention. Primary prevention is to identify the high risk population who may go into chronic kidney disease or kidney failure and they may later on need dialysis. So who are those patients? Generally, patients who are diabetic, hypertensive, old age, having stone problems, that is kidney stone problems, having recurrent urine infections, they are more prone to go into kidney disease. So we have to target this population so they do not go into further deterioration of the kidneys. Second thing is about the secondary prevention, that the patient who are already having kidney problem, as you all know or you must be aware, there is some we generally as a community we see serum creatinine, serum potassium and urine reports to diagnose the kidney problem. So we see these markers regularly, and to monitor these markers and to take steps to delay the progression of kidney problems. So how can we do that? We can first, in the primary prevention, main thing is lifestyle modification. So the patient should be taking adequate amount of water. That's the main important thing. It is not about how much water, it is about not to keep you dehydrated. It forms the basis to avoid most of the kidney problems, especially stone problems. However, when the kidney problem is deteriorating, that the patient goes into stage 3, stage 4 kidney problem, we try to avoid the intake of water, especially patients who have concomitant or accompanying any heart problem. These patients are not able to filter more of urine, more of water through the kidneys. So we need to limit it. So it varies in patient to patient, in patients having kidney problem as well as heart disease. And we try to make the patient euvolemic. Matlab, patient ko sujan na aaye, aur patient ka BP, blood pressure, sab control mein rahe. Iske liye hum patient ko medicine dete hain, ki unka BP control mein rahe, unka paani badan mein na bhare. इसके लिए हम मेडिसिन यूज करते हैं. वी ट्राई टू लिमिट द वाटर इनटेक एंड द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट सॉल्ट इनटेक. द सॉल्ट इनटेक हैज टू आल्सो बी टेकन केयर ऑफ. द पेशेंट शुड बी अवेयर दैट ही हैज अ किडनी प्रॉब्लम, ही हैज अ हाइपरटेंसिव प्रॉब्लम, बीपी प्रॉब्लम. तो सॉल्ट इनटेक कम करना चाहिए. वी कैन ऑल्सो, देर आर मेनी सॉल्ट सब्स्टिट्यूट्स सच एज खड़ा नमक और रॉक सॉल्ट, और वी हैव other parameters which are available in the market, or in the market they are saying the low salt diet. We avoid that because it contains high potassium. Potassium also is cause problem to the kidneys. We can use salt substitutes such as tamarind, lemon juice. We can use spices, herbs, to give the taste and make the food palatable. Second thing is use of the foods which are having low phosphate. Now, phosphate is also known to cause high progression of kidney problems. So avoid food, lean meats, avoid meats, red meats, our take of fish is better. The protein intake also depends upon the stage of kidney problem. Now the patient who is on stage 1, stage 2 kidney problems, we try to decrease the protein intake. So that is, if kidneys are not stressed with excess of protein. So we try to keep the kidney protein intake to normally 0.8 gram per kg per day. Normally the diet contains around 1 gram per kg per day. And that protein has to be high biological value, and preferably plant-based protein or soy protein. Second thing is avoid water, avoid red meat. Red meat is not to be taken. A patient who are having, some patients have something called a nephrotic syndrome. It means that the patient is losing protein in the urine. In such patient, we have to replenish the protein in the diet. But obviously, we have to keep a balance regarding the kidney function. Other things which are helpful are some drugs to decrease the protein progression. The kidney disease progression. So use some medicines to decrease the metabolic acidosis. Metabolic acidosis is nothing but when the kidney gets deteriorated, the acid or the toxins get accumulated in the body. So we supplement the patient with bicarbonate. We supplement the patient with calcium. The calcium is low in patient of kidney disease. So all these parameters has to be monitored. The vitamin D deficiency is also known to accelerate the progression of kidney disease in some of the trials. So it is important to monitor the vitamin D levels and to replenish the levels through medicines if required to de-accelerate the progression of the kidney disease. The third thing, main thing we can do is using some medicines to decrease the deterioration of kidney function, especially patients having proteinuria in the urine. So when you go to a doctor, especially you are diabetic, hypertensive, you monitor the urine reports. If the urine is showing protein, especially in diabetic patient, that indicates their kidney deterioration is in a starting phase. So we keep a watch on the protein level in the urine. There are some medicines which decrease the amount of protein in the urine. It is said that in many trials that the more amount of protein in the urine is one of the causes for deterioration of renal function. So we use something called as renin-angiotensin aldosterone inhibitors. These are ACE inhibitors or ARBs. We use patients, but we monitor the potassium of the patient. Again, this depends upon patient to patient. We have to keep a watch on the potassium levels, the creatinine levels, and the general appearance or the lab parameters of the patient. Second thing is about the lifestyle modification. As I told you, you should keep a watch. The patient should quit smoking. The alcohol consumption should be in the minimum. Also, the patient should have a regular mild exercise, such as 15 to 20 minutes of mild to moderate exercise daily, or five times in a week at least, so that his physical parameters of lab parameters about the kidney disease are taken care of. If you have any questions, I'm taking it, so I'm just keeping a note on it. About the phosphorus, it's very important to avoid high phosphorus food. Use dairy product, use of low phosphorus foods which are low in foods which are low in phosphorus, such as fresh fruits. Use breads, brown breads. Use corn leaves. Do not use colas at all. Dark colored colas are known to have a high phosphorus content in them. So avoid that scenario. Second, the last important thing is the regular follow up. Now when the creatinine is a very labile marker. It depends upon the diet, it depends upon the patient characteristics, it depends upon the race, the ethnicity. So always keep a regular follow-up with the nephrologist regarding the creatinine level and the other parameters in the blood which are related to kidney. The patient should be on regular follow-up for the hemoglobin, patients of kidney disease have a low erythropoietin levels, because erythropoietin is a hormone which is made in the kidney. So patients who are having low hemoglobin or anemia, we give them erythropoietin supplements or injections to keep the hemoglobin at a certain level. Also, the patient should be monitored for any uric acid problems. So the uric acid lowering drugs can be given to the patient, such as febuxostat or xyloric, that is allopurinol, to decrease the progression of kidney disease. The other parameters, as the patient starts aging, he has deterioration of renal function because of the aging, and overall the secondary factors such as diabetes, hypertension do cause a major deterioration of the kidney problems. The patients having stage 3, stage 4 up to that level, we give something called as alpha keto analogs to some of the patients. In large controlled trials, it has shown that it's helpful in patients to decrease the progression of renal disease. So that can be given to patients who are eligible in that level. Patients who are stage 5 and above, we try to limit their progression to dialysis, again through a limited through the regulation of the medicines, then regulation of the diet, as well as proper follow-up. The patients who are on stage 3, stage 4, stage 5 have to be followed up more frequently than in patients of stage 1 and stage 2. The patient who are going in stage 3, stage 4 or progressing to stage 6, they are advised for renal transplantation if required, and they are counseled about the same. But it is very important to keep a regular follow-up with the doctors or the nephrologist regarding the optimum treatment. But the things should be on the both side. The patient should also be aware of his problems, and he should not take it lightly. Especially patients, or of some patients tend to have a lot of painkillers. Now, painkillers is not at all recommended in patients of kidney problems. So if you have many market, we have Combiflam, Sumoflam, Ibuprofen. It is not at all recommended. It is toxic to the kidneys. You can use paracetamol or tramadol in place of these drugs for the pain or headache or fever. There are many antibiotics also, such as aminoglycosides, which tend to have a problem nephrotoxic effect. In the sense, they cause a toxic effect to the kidneys if you use them without any supervision. So if you have any doubt regarding the drugs, especially kidney patients having a borderline creatinine, it is important that you follow up with your nephrologist and take his permission before starting any new medicines which are prescribed by a general practitioner or family physician who is not aware of the drug's nephrotoxic side effects. So if you have any
Okay.